Okay, so here we have the home menu of the 3DS. This is pretty much the default display when you boot up the operating system for the first time. I just want to show off a few basic features. So obviously you have all the icons along here. You just can scroll across like that or tap these arrows. But what I like is up here is you can easily change how many icons are in each row. So just tap that button, goes down to two rows and then three rows and keeps going like that. Still, it gets pretty small, so that's quite good. And you just click on this icon to make it bigger again. I prefer to have as many icons on the screen as possible while still being a fairly decent size, so this configuration seems to work the best. Then we have the brightness settings. So I have it on 5 for these videos, but if it's general playing, actually just playing on just one, it's still pretty good. It doesn't look that good on video right now, but in real life it isn't too bad. So you might want to consider that if you just want to save a lot of battery life. And then up here we have the game notes feature, which you can access pretty much at any time. As long as you're not in like an online game or something, you can just boot up the home menu, access all these icons at the top. And this type of stuff is for really anything. The example they sort of give is if you're in a part of a game that's sort of difficult, you might like write down some notes so you can remember some little detail later on. Actually, I just realized I didn't turn the brightness back up, so I'll go back. I don't imagine I'm going to be using this feature too much, but maybe if you're playing like some really detailed strategy game or some RPG or something, then it could come in handy, so you can just draw around different colours, the eraser, and I believe so you can just wipe it, or you can save it to your photo library too. Get rid of that. And then we have, let's see, what's the next? We have the friends list. I have actually shown this off another video, so I won't go through all of it, but obviously you can just scroll through the friends list. There's a couple people, myself and my mate Muhammad. And then you can add people up here. Pretty standard stuff. It looks really good and it's fast enough and all that, but I have done another video about that, so you can check out that if you want to. Then we have, I guess just the web browser, because just to point out the fact that the web browser is not activated at the moment. That's where it would be, but it's not coming out till late May, so can't show it off yet. But here we have the notifications tab, which has been surprisingly active so far. I'll just go through everything, I guess. So it starts off with a bunch of notifications from Nintendo, just like basic use on how to use 3DS, that kind of stuff. I can't read any of this tips, but I just know it's that. And then, so we got some content from Street Fighter. That was from Street Pass, so I walked past someone who had a Street Fighter save file. I imagine, I guess, our 3DS has had a little mini battle. Haven't checked the results of that yet, but that's pretty neat. We've got someone from Ridge Racer. So that would be a ghost, so if I boot up the game again, I can race against someone's ghost and try to beat their time. Then we have a system update, which I've also made a video about. That was the first firmware upgrade. Then another one from Street Fighter. This was actually from SpotPass, so this came from the internet, automatically downloaded, and it was just an extra trophy. Nothing too special, but I think Capcom were just testing out the feature. And we have this new one from Samurai Warriors Chronicle. I'm not actually sure what this is, but I imagine just some small piece of content, sort of similar to that trophy. And that is the notifications feature. And that's pretty much the entirety of the home menu. I'd go into settings, but most of the settings are pretty confusing. Actually, I'll show you a couple things. I won't be able to get through most of it though, because I've been ignoring as much as I can, because like I said, I can't read Japanese, so it's sort of difficult. But we have Wi-Fi settings. That was actually surprisingly easy to set the Wi-Fi network up. Parental controls, and so I'm guessing, oh, that's all like the DSi weight transfer, I guess. And then stuff I sort of understand is basic system settings. So we have your nickname. There's your nickname, so you can change that around. And then you got birth date. I believe this is location. I'm not too sure, but apparently I live somewhere in Japan now. And I believe this should be, yeah, so you got date, and then you got, this should be time, yep, so there's time. And oh, this is like calibration screen. too exciting. And yeah, most of the other stuff, so we've got microphone testing. That's not picking up anything at the moment though. And yeah, nothing too crazy. This is the button for updating the firmware, but I've always shown that off in another video, so no need to look at that. And I guess I'll just look at the Wi-Fi section quickly. Okay, I gotta remember how I did this. So to set up the Wi-Fi network, so I've already got all three set up, but it's pretty simple. You just, pretty sure you click the blue button, there'll be an empty spot here, and then it'll just take, you can just keep clicking okay. So keep clicking on the right option, and eventually you just have to put in the password for the network that you select from a list. Pretty standard stuff. And if I can understand any Japanese, it must be pretty easy. And that is pretty much the entire home menu. Pretty much all the settings I can understand. If you want more specific videos, if you want to know how to exactly do something, I can probably find it out. Just keep fumbling around until I get to it. But that is it for now, so I will talk to you later. Make sure you subscribe for more videos. Leave a comment below, and yep, that is it.